former President Trump continuing in a Denver courtroom today.
Yeah, this would be day three now. It's part of a state effort to take the former president off the upcoming 2024 presidential ballot. Drew has been following this. Drew, what's happened? What's going on this week? I mean, not even this week, yesterday and then into today.
So trial day two was yesterday, day three today. You're right on that part, Kirk. And they expect this trial only to last just about a week, so a short trial. We could have a decision by the end of the week. But it's focused on the rare nature of the constitutional clause that state attorneys are pressing in this case. A group of Colorado voters arguing that Trump's role, here's video from day two of the trial yesterday in the Denver courtroom, in the January 6th attack on the Capitol should disqualify the former president from running for another term. State attorneys are basing this on part of the 14th Amendment, which bans insurrectionists from running for office. Meantime, Trump's attorney is arguing he did not take part in an insurrection and trying to drive home the gravity of this case, saying this would be the first time in history that a judge would ban someone from running for president under that clause of the Constitution.
The Trump campaign says it's a frivolous attempt to thwart the will of the voters and to short-circuit the democratic process.
Now, the amendment section in question here was mostly used during the Reconstruction era, so we're talking after the Civil War. The former president faces similar lawsuits, told you about this yesterday, in two other states, Michigan and Minnesota, later on this week. But many believe the decision in this case and the other two states will be appealed, and this case will eventually make its way all the way up to the nation's highest court. Of course, Kirk and Lisa talking about the Supreme Court. So would that be done in time? Would the decision be made in time before we even get to the point where your name would be on the presidential ballot? We'd have to wait and see. But again, this trial should be wrapped up by the end of the week. Of course, something we'll be tracking, and they'll get started again today in a couple hours. We'll bring you some live pictures from that court.
Yeah, I mean, in some cases, for a case to go from local courts to Supreme Court
years.
Can take years.
Absolutely. Yeah. That's why a lot of people are saying, well, if it's going to go that high, why are we even in this predicament in the first place? But we'll have to wait and see.
Right. And then, of course, the national implications that could then follow.
For sure.